worldtabletennis.com and cast your vote.
Love one.
Nice start by the Indians.
Love.
Interesting setup of the game. Satyan Gyanasekaran has to be more aggressive to grab some points. Oh, that's a wonderful backhand down the line from Kim. Not too surprised. That's something she's done very often in the singles game.
3-all.
The Indians coached by their coach Aman Balgu sitting from there. Yeah, they got a good point for the Indians, both of them. Making those two unforced errors, actually. Starting with your forehand is so critical, especially in the game of doubles where you have to be more aggressive from the word go.
6-3.
And the Koreans have taken a swooping lead. 6-3 in the first game. Nice use of long pimples from Manika Batra. Remember, she uses the long pimples on her backhand side, which produces an absolutely opposite effect of what you give the ball back.
Three, go. 4-7.
Koreans way too comfortable at this point in the match so far. That forehand chop from Park keeping Satyan really, really.
7-5.
That's a wonderful smash from Manika Batra, followed by a good counter-attack from Satyan Gyanasekaran. Look at it one more time. That smash is something she's very proud of. Very risky shots and difficult to hit.
8-1.
And the Indians close out on that long lead from the Koreans. Beautiful, absolutely stunning. So comfortable from the Koreans right there. Park coming in with that big forehand. And then Kim just gliding through the ball. Cross court, wide angle of forehands. Oh, a lot of things happening in that rally. There was a twiddle from Manika Batra. And then she followed up with a backhand from the soft rubber, more aggressive on the extreme forehand of Kim. Last rally was 8 shots, I believe the longest rally so far in the match. from Satyen. Where did that come from? Well, he's been doing that many times in the singles match, but seeing him doing in doubles is absolutely impressive. And the Indians now have one game point. And they wrap that game. 11-9. To help with the balls.
One love.
Well, the tomahawk serves working really well. Seeing Manika Batra do that first time in this match so far. Yeah, and that's what the Koreans need to do. Stay probably more closer to the table and go more aggressive. That forehand from Kim was so smooth. Oh, absolutely brilliant and wonderful selection of space to hit on Manika Batra's backhand from Park. Look at that 14 shot rally. So impressive.
Got it.
And Manika responds back with that backhand block from the long pimple side. That ball's it goes down really flat near the net and has a lot of backspin. The Koreans are finding it more uncomfortable as we get deep into this match. Scores tied up 3-3 in the second game. And you hear that show from Satyen, really boosting each other. The positivity overall he's shown, I've been really impressed by him. And why that is because he's been struggling with a lot of injury issues for the very first time in his career. Just brilliant setup of that match. I think everything that happened there was so world class. I actually thought the Indians would take up that point, but Park came back from behind with that wonderful forehand spin. Nice, that was the twiddle from the racket on the backhand side. You could see the twiddle from the black's rubber. Manika Batra needs to do that much more often to surprise her opponents. That 13-shot rally was quite world-class. Beautiful serve. That shovel serve is actually so deceptive from Kim. I think she should continue doing that, because the serve and the receive game is so critical in TT. Where did that come from? Well, quite lethal, I would say. If I was to play against Park right now, it would be quite intimidating. But inside out, forehand. Tell the strategy by the Indians, because not really seen Manika Batra making use of her long pimples very well. Koreans have been keeping the ball a lot on the forehand side. That's more like it. A bit of a turn, moving around and playing from the long pimples. Looks like she heard me there. Koreans have closed down the lead so well. 6 of the last 8 points for them.
7-10.
And yet another one. And now 3 game points for the Koreans. Well, and that's the end of the second game.
One love.
Nice start by Kim there. A bit of vocal in executing that forehand.
Love two.
Brilliant start from the Koreans. An early lead in this third game could just do so much good for their confidence. Remember, this is a best of 5 match. And the third game is so critical. They also lost the first game from this very combination. So it's interesting to see an early start from them. 4 love. Well, I think they really have followed the coach's advice. Just so much more aggressive, so much more impact in the attacks. You can see from the Koreans that impact in the backhand from Park and Kim following it up. Nice move from Manika Batra. Very brave, I would say. First style break of this match. In the third game so far.
Let 1-5.
Nice back and a bit of a strawberry there from Manika Batra from the long pimple side. And I love how low it was to the net. The Koreans were not really ready for how low that ball went.
6-2.
Very comfortable lead here for the Koreans.
Six, three.
Just subtle changes in receiving can also make such a big difference in the game of table tennis. Both the receivings from Sat and Gyanasekaran were actually very different. He set the ball really well for Manika. I'm sure she's quite gutted to miss that smash. Look at that once again. The ball quite literally dropped. Had a bit of a backspin in there. Wow, brilliant.
7.
Counter attack from Satyan. He kind of just like rightly glided through, put his racket just on the ball, following it through, using the pace of the opponent to send the ball back. Very swift and smooth. Well, that was a planned long serve, but not really in their favor. The Koreans lead 8-4 in game 3. You can see all through the match how dominating the attacks have been from the Koreans. And also the lefty-righty combination working so very well in their favor.
9-4.
Well, a bit of fortune. Ball hitting the top of the net court. And now 6 game points for the Koreans. Nice forehand from Manika. And a bit of a poker face from her there. Still going so focused and strong. Aiming to close out that lead. That long lead. Not really 11, successful
five,
game in
game
favor of the Koreans, who've been so dominant. But here we are back in this fourth game. Well, the Indians really have to pull up their socks. And every single point in this fourth game is going to be so critical for them. Where it's gonna come. Look at how swiftly he moves across. And a banana opening from Satin. A bit of a change in body language from the Indians. More aggressive this time. Manika Batra using that forehand down the line. So very well. Crowd support can also do so much wonders to your overall confidence.
Five.
And a very comfortable 5-1 lead. So interesting to see how both the pairs are leading and winning on the opposite combination of actually where they lost the games. It's kind of a match of equals, although you can't tell with the world rank because the Indians are number 11 and Koreans 84th in the world. Look at the body language as well. How confidently he goes, sweeps the ball, that backhand attack. And the coach there, so ecstatic as well. They really needed that point and the lead. Well, they follow it up with yet another one. As simple as that, attack is your best friend, right? Just go for it. And that last rally was 9 shots. And most of them were made off the attacks.
4-7.
That point ended up really quick. But the forehand spin from Park was quite spinny. A lot of rotation.
8-4.
I can see such a massive change in the body language of both the pairs there. Unforced error. from the Korean. You can see how unhappy he was.
Close it.
9-4.
A lot of backspin serve. A short, nice backspin serve grabs you another point. Oh, very brave from Satyen to grab that forehand back, but no. Well, if you're facing Park and his big forehand spin, you can't really match up with that angular forehand topspin. Deep on the forehand side.
6-9.
Good surprise, long serve. Seeing probably for the first time in this match so far.
Go!
10-6.
That forehand was so, so comfortable for Satyen. That show said it all. He kind of knew that he wanted to do it. And now 4 game points for the Indians to level this match 2-2 and go into the deciding.
10,
not yet.
7.
The Koreans save one. Been as high as 5 in the world. And playing in front of the home crowd in India. And as you head into Paris Olympic preparations, it's just so much for them to grab from within this tournament itself. Oh, Kim, so absolutely brilliant with that forehand attack. Kind of on the middle, the body side of Manika Batra. Look at that. Oh, how confusing that was. Where did that come from, King? That he just turned around and that attack. Look at that one more time. Spinning in it, and it, if you have long pimples, which Manika has on the backhand side, sometimes really hard to just cross over the net. Brilliant. Just wonderful movement around the table from the Indians. Look at Satyen, he was almost displayed, but very well ready to grab that forehand extreme side. 10 shots in that last rally. We want more, don't we? Man, this is so neck to neck. It's almost like all of them are just doing everything possible. And every single point is so, so dominant and so close.
Left, 2-4.
Notice when Manika serves, sometimes there's a quick twiddle from her side. She did it last time, although it was a let serve. Not again, but good enough to grab that point. An error that Kim not really thought that she could make. And look at her face, how disappointed she would be. Yeah, that was a crucial point. The Indians trying to now close out that lead. Which they did. Satyen Gyanasekaran, that disruptive forehand attack. I mean, how good is that? As good as it can get, Satyen. Cross court, far, far edge of the table. So good. exchanges is just so breathtaking. Kim has been so dominant. I mean, one of the most impressive players for me so far in this tournament. 9 shots in that last rally, and you can see the length of every single point, kind of maintaining that balance. 8 to 9 shots, long rallies. Really the game of table tennis that we want to see. You would imagine to actually get that ball back, how disappointed Manika was to miss that shot. It was right there in her comfortable space, and that O from the coach also said it all. 2-point lead for the Koreans.
Four.
I mean, the setup of the rally was so good. That defensive backhand block from Manika, giving an extra edge. But well, Park, oh my God, that ball had so much spin. She does it. Well, the coach really knows best. And credit to Manika to follow the advice of the coach and close out that lead from 1 point, that tomahawk serve. Look at that once again with a lot of rotation. Kim coming and trying to make a nice opening, but no. And Satyen also following the advice of their coach, Aman Balbu. What a wonderful combination the three of them are currently making. And the Koreans have now called a timeout. Well, a bit of a luck for Manika Batra. She almost kind of struggled to give that push back. The ball was having not too much in that, but it went deep on the side, on the long side of forehand side. And that smile from Kim says that, oops, I should have made it back. 2-2, 7-7. Nice spinny topspin. The serve, Satyen kind of wanting to keep it short, but went out. Park really using that opportunity with that lovely forehand. Yes, that's how it is. That aggressive backhand side push from Manika, and Satyen closing it out from his forehand. That is actually their strength. And if they can continue doing it, they could make the Indian fans here in this Pedamendo Stadium happy. Beautiful. Such a dominant play from Manika Batra. Down the line, forehand attack. Choosing the spot so very well. It's so hard at this stage to make on the shorter side of the table. Well done from the Indians.
9-all.
Too early. They say you gotta always stay calm and hold your nerves tight. Satyen needed that advice right there. Towards the end. 9-9 in this deciding game. Manika Batra to serve. Will it be the tomahawk? Yes, it is. But nine, point to the Koreans. Ten. Well, Kim really saving the day. An apology as the ball hit the net court. There you can see. The ball changes its pace a little bit. Satyen not at all happy, calling out for help. Fire! absolutely 11, 9, brilliant. The Koreans just came in and finished that with